Well, a lot of the conversation about climate change in California is focused on the drought, but sea level rise is another impact. As KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman explains, even inland parts of the state could face consequences.
Sea level rise. It's a looming threat to all of California as global temperatures increase due to human-caused climate change.
Sea level rise is not the answer to our water challenges in California. It actually works against us.
27 million Californians rely on water that flows through the Delta. That water is salt-free, and it needs to stay that way for us to use. But it's exactly where water from the Pacific would push into as ocean levels rise.
If that area were to become salty, it would take at least 2 years to regenerate those freshwater conditions.
Climate models estimate that for every degree of warming, the average global ocean level will rise another 7.5 feet. And our current carbon use patterns have already made that just about inevitable this century.
According to global research put together by Climate Central, 1 degree Celsius of warming could lead to seawater inundation for the Delta region that looks like this. It's outlined here in the red area. But if you bump that up to 2 degrees Celsius, seawater pushes even further inland. Some of the more extreme tidal projections have ocean water in Midtown Sacramento.
Earlier this month, the Department of Water Resources filled in a temporary dam designed to keep saltwater away from the Central Delta during drought years.
We're able to keep this interior delta fresh with the release of less fresh water from our upstream reservoirs, including Lake Oroville and Lake Shasta.
Another more long-term plan is the Delta Conveyance Project, first introduced in the 1950s. It would create a sort of underground water bypass, keeping fresh water separate from natural delta waterways.
The Delta Conveyance Project itself is a game changer from all those prior potential projects or alternative projects.
The idea is controversial. It involves building over 40 miles of tunnels through rural communities. Those opposed say it would disrupt lifestyles and the environment. But one way or another, researchers know
the Delta is like the heart of California.
A heart that needs to be protected as sea level rise creeps closer and closer to the front of people's minds. For KCRA 3 News, I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman.
Now, another potential natural buffer to sea level rise is rehabilitating wetland areas throughout the Delta. That would help the ecosystem become a bit more resilient.